A useful feature to know in charting is the ability to add a trend line into a chart. So you'll see here we've got a chart, and if you look at it, we're just doing product A, and it's very clear there seems to be a trend and it looks like it's upwards. But if we want to add a trend line into a chart, it's extremely easy. I'll just right click on any one of the series, and you'll see there's an option here called add trend line. When I do it, a line comes in and immediately we've got a trend line. You'll notice over here that the trend line has got a whole bunch of options. So again, if you click somewhere else, you'd see something else, but when you click on the trend line, you get all the options to format a trend line. You have the standard ones, so if you don't like the color or you want to change things like that, you can change the line, the style, etc. But the important ones are here. You can define how the trend line is calculated. So by default, it goes straight to linear regression. So it's just a straight line like that. But if you understand how they work and what they mean, you've got an option for exponential, and you'll see it's slightly different. And then there's logarithmic and polynomial and power. There's also a moving average. So you can say, take it in this case a 2-period, so our periods are months. So this is a 2-month moving average. I'm going to go back to linear. You'll see you can change the name, so the trend line name can either be linear product A, or you can give it a custom name. Notice as well you have the ability to forecast. So I'm going to forecast forward. I'm going to say, using this line, please go forward, and let's make it 6 periods. And what you'll see is it takes that line and draws it further forward. You can go back to 0. It also allows you to change the intercept. So at the moment, it by default is started at whatever the calculation says, but we can force it to start at a different number. And very useful for anyone who's statistically minded is I can display the equation on the chart. So here's the equation, and I can display the R squared. So you can see R squared, for anyone who doesn't know, it's how good this fit is. And the closer you get to 1, the better the fit. So this is effectively 88%, so it's a very, very good fit. So you can easily set up the trend line and easily see what it looks like.